4, 3, 2, 1.
Cue music.
This is Movies First with Alex First.
Motherless Brooklyn is a convoluted but compelling, if overly long, drama about a private eye with a photographic memory who's carrying a neurodevelopmental disorder and a powerful city official who wields total control. The title's drawn from a nickname given to the flawed hero by his boss, who's dispensed with early in the piece. Mind you, it's an unsolved puzzle left after his boss's demise that drives his devoted employee to chase a city official down a proverbial drainpipe. This is a piece of film noir about power and dispossession. The year is 1957, and Lionel Esrog, Edward Norton, is a lonely private detective living with Tourette syndrome. He ventures to solve the murder of his mentor and only friend, Frank Minna, Bruce Willis. Armed only with a few clues and the engine of his obsessive mind, Esrog unravels closely guarded secrets that hold the fate of New York in the balance. It's a mystery that carries Esrog from gin-soaked jazz clubs in Harlem and the hard-edged slums of Brooklyn to the gilded halls of New York's power brokers. He contends with thugs, corruption, and the most dangerous man in the city, developer Moses Randolph, played by Alec Baldwin, to honour someone who stood by him and to try to save the woman who might be his own salvation.
You're listening to Movies First. For more, like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
Written and directed by Norton, his first directorial feature since Keeping the Faith in 2000, and his first piece of screenwriting, Motherless Brooklyn is based upon Jonathan Lethem's 1999 novel of the same name. Ed Norton is strong as the central focus, helming the meandering storyline in spite of his character's unfortunate affliction. Gugu Mbatha-Raw is sympathetic as Laura Rose, someone who doesn't realise all that's going on around her. I did struggle with some overacting, particularly that by Alec Baldwin early in the piece. However, it wasn't an issue for me as the story developed. I also felt there were plot holes and leaps of faith you had to have to swallow what was being fed. And it certainly didn't need to be pushing 2.5 hours to get it all said. While it's a movie that requires concentration to follow, I appreciated the period setting and the attention to detail that involved. So while Motherless Brooklyn is not without its challenges, I was still drawn in by the premise and by a significant amount of the endeavour. It scores a 7 out of 10.
You've been listening to Movies First with Alex First.
Available at Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, or your favourite podcast player. You can also stream on demand at Bytes.com.
This has been another quality podcast production from Bytes.com.